Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My dear brothers and sisters, indeed it's a privilege again for us to break yet another day of our fast for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we continue on to another day in the blessed month of Ramadan as we come closer and closer to the end of Ramadan. Indeed, this portion of Ramadan that we are about to enter, the third portion of Ramadan, it is one of the most auspicious time in the month of Ramadan. It is the period in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has increased in the favors and the bounties to his servants. And amongst the favors and the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon his servants is that the mention of the night of Laylatul Qadr, for us to seek Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And amongst these as well is to seek ourselves protection from the fire of the hell. And also in relationship to this, we are also reminded most of all, it's important to make i'tikaf. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has emphasized the importance of i'tikaf upon his ummah and upon himself, as he, the Messenger of Allah, has also encouraged his wives to also be involved in i'tikaf. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions to us in hadith that Aisha radiallahu ta'ala narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, kana ya'takifu al-ashr al-awakhira min ramadana hatta tawafahu Allah thumma atakafa azwajuhu min ba'dihi. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said and observed the i'tikaf regularly in the last 10 days of Ramadan till the end of his life. After his death, his wives continued with it. The hadith is found in Sahih Bukhari that the importance of the i'tikaf for us to fulfill this right of secluding ourselves. And what is really i'tikaf? You know, we see that the Prophet ﷺ made a lot of emphasis on this. The very mere fact that i'tikaf was something that the Rasul ﷺ before his prophethood had done in cave of Hira in the hope and the expectation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have provided that level of guidance and in the Rasul ﷺ receiving the Quran from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, receiving the message of the Quran through Angel Jibreel alayhi salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during the period of the i'tikaf that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would perform. And more so that the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw the great reward of Laylatul Qadr in the last portion of this. And then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have been given that opportunity to us and says, seek it. Seek this night within the last 10 nights. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, what is really seclusion when it comes to an individual in our time? It is for an individual to put themselves in an environment where we can actually feel and attach ourselves closely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ignoring and taking away the essence of the daily routine that we'll fulfill in our lives. That we no longer find ourselves attached to the activities of the world as we would normally attach ourselves to the activities of the world. The only distraction that can come to us during this time of i'tikaf, those who would observe the rites of i'tikaf, will be the necessities that one, personal necessities, will entail using a washroom, a shower, and for all or most of it, a rest, a sleep within i'tikaf, in the place of i'tikaf, and also the needs and necessity of eating and breaking of the fast and the suhoor in the morning. And these are all part of the ibadat and worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well, as we know. So my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we are in a time when it's very difficult for any one of us to observe i'tikaf at the masjid. And we know there's a special restriction to the amount of people that can go to the masjid, and that we are prevented from attending the masjid. But if, however, we can actually fulfill that right in our masajids, at least one person or two persons, and bearing in mind the number of persons that can come to the masjid, at least these two persons or one person, as the case would be, making i'tikaf in the masjid will be a sense of obligation being fulfilled for the entire community. And that is a blessing for us to observe as well. So once we have that capability, and one individual from amongst our community, from amongst our brothers who are willing to make the ethical, then at least allow that amount to be taken care of by this one individual. At least all of us may not be able to observe that ethical, but at least in the masjid, at least that right is fulfilled. But however, the ibadat and the worship that is done in these nights and days in i'tikaf, an individual who may not be in i'tikaf in the masjid, whether it is in i'tikaf in the essence of being complete with all of the haqs and the rights and the hukuk of i'tikaf as in the masjid, as opposed to doing a nafil i'tikaf where a person is in and out of i'tikaf, then he still observes a level of i'tikaf with some level of restrictions as well as a level of devotion that is more in particular in these nights and days. So therefore, if we are in our homes, we are in the environment where we can still do ibadat and worship to Allah consistently and constantly in that condition, that we do more than normal even in our homes. So don't think that, well, we are not able to make i'tikaf in the masjid because the number of people can be there, but we can still do the ibadat and the worship. Allahu alam, Allah knows best the reward for what we would have gotten in the masjid, but our intention was for the masjid. Our intention is to spend time in the masjid. Then we cannot do that, but Allah knows, because we are restricted based on the conditions that we are facing. Before us today, the entire country and the world is facing some big challenge when it comes to COVID-19. So therefore, we have to make sure that we observe those regulations and stick to them. But also remember that our time in the month of Ramadan is also limited, because Ramadan is not going to stay here and remain with us for us much longer. So therefore, take advantage of the remaining days in the month of Ramadan and the days of i'tikaf with the last 10 days, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through His infinite mercy, give us the ability to understand that we are in that final days and final moments in this month. We take advantage of it and mind ourselves that we should always remember that i'tikaf puts us in an environment that we come close to Allah. We try to attach ourselves to Allah. We try to restrict our affairs in the world, and we try to connect with every type of devotion that will make us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that ability to work on it, inshallah. We'll continue some more discussion on i'tikaf in our homes, or those will be doing i'tikaf in the masjid, and those who be in some level of i'tikaf in relation of spending some time within our home for i'tikaf, because i'tikaf really cannot be done in our homes for the males, only for the females. So maybe an opportunity is here for sisters as well to take advantage of it, inshallah. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the guidance on this, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the reward for the special days that are waiting for us to take full advantage of, inshallah. May Allah accept your fasting and my fasting, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the true rewards of it in this life and the life of the hereafter, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.